Tonight I'm making my cheesy spinach stuffed shells, and I'm gonna throw in a little Italian sausage in there too, because why not? And I think we'll have that with a salad. But I'm gonna bring you along on how I made it. Shells are cooking in here and they take about 9 minutes. My recipe says to cook up 16 shells, but I always do about 20 just in case some of them break or tear. And then while those cook, I'm going to cook up this hot Italian sausage. If you don't like spicy, you can use their mild one, but this is just the brand and package that I buy, and I cook up the whole thing. I actually like to cook the noodles al dente because they are gonna bake in the oven, so you don't want them to be too mushy. And then I'm going to preheat my oven to 375. Boom. Sausage here is cooking up on medium-high heat. You don't have to add any oil into the pan since the sausage has enough grease in it. It won't stick to your pan, especially if using a nonstick. Okay, drained my noodles, and I am setting them on parchment paper here so they don't stick together in your pot. And we'll just kind of line them up and get ready to fill them. We're gonna make the cheese filling, the meat is finishing cooking up. It'll be delicious. It's a perfect example of a noodle that broke. So, I mean, I can still fill him up, but you know, if I were to take pictures of this or maybe like present this to someone at a dinner party, that wouldn't look as pretty as one that's not broken. I took the Italian sausage off the stove and put it in a bowl, and I'm just gonna set it to the side while we make the rest of the filling. To save time on dishes, I'm just gonna use the same pan that the meat was in. Gonna drizzle a little olive oil in here. Once that heats up, about 30 seconds to a minute, I will add some garlic and then wilt 4 cups of spinach in this guy. Pan is nice and hot. You hear that sizzle. Just use my finger to get that garlic in there. I'm just doing two cloves. You can do more. Sometimes when a recipe says 2 cloves, I add like 6 cloves. So you do you with the garlic. You don't want the garlic to burn, so we're gonna add in all that spinach, 4 cups, kind of packed it in there. I know it looks like a lot, but it'll basically wilt down to nothing, trust me. And you want it to look just about like that, and then I'll place it in a bowl, set it aside, and now we can finally make the cheese filling. Here's what we're working with, you guys. There's ricotta in there. I'm gonna whisk this little egg right here, throw him in. Doesn't have to be completely whisked. So toss that whisked egg in there with the cheese. We have 1/2 cup of Parmesan, grated Parm. I have some mozzarella shredded. My recipe says like 1 cup, but I think that's a little bit more than 1 cup tonight. Some salt and garlic powder. And over here, I chopped up some fresh basil, and then we have our spinach that we wilted. Add all that in and give it a nice big stir. I have my jar of sauce, and I'm going to line my baking pan. I'm just using a 9x13 baking dish with a little bit of the sauce, just so the noodles don't stick. I'll get the back of a spoon here and spread it around. And now we get to start to build our shells. So if you went with the Italian sausage way, you'll just take your Italian sausage, place it down in one of the noodles, and then top it with your cheese filling. I'll grab another spoon. Maybe just about 1 teaspoon of the sausage. And same thing for the cheese. Maybe that's 1 tablespoon for the cheese there. Make them nice and stuffed. Place it down in your pan and repeat with the following shells. Oh my gosh, you guys, these are looking so good. Got them all filled, and I'm going to top with this additional red sauce. More the merrier. And then I'll cover with foil. Oh, I have a little guy here too, since I made a few extra. cover with foil, and then bake for 25 minutes with the foil on, and then about 5 to 10 minutes with the foil off, and with a little bit of extra cheese on top if you'd like.
Now, while those are in the oven for 25 minutes, there's plenty of things you could be doing, right? You could be checking the mail, folding the laundry, I don't know, doing the dishes that we just created, but instead, we're gonna do this tonight.
It's been 25 minutes, so I'm just going to sprinkle these with cheese. Rugby is barking like crazy. And then let these cook for another maybe like 5 to 10 minutes. And that's it. Cameron just walked in the door. Perfect timing, ready for dinner. Hope you guys like this one.